Hey everyone, today we're going to continue to explore JavaScript inside of Articulate Storyline 360, and we're going to focus more today on doing complex math and the benefits of doing this inside of JavaScript rather than doing it with several different triggers. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batts with Learning Dojo, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering anything learning development. You can also check out different templates. You can download templates on Articulate Storyline 360. You can also download templates with XAPI video templates, PDF XAPI templates. And if you're new to any learning development tools, you can check out full courses, everything from Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. Now, I've already covered a lot of different JavaScript triggers inside of Articulate Storyline 360, so go ahead and check out my YouTube channel if you want to see more about that subject. But today we're going to focus on complex math. Now, I remember when I was building templates for a company and I was building different game templates, to figure out a certain percentage, I would have to add a lot or create a lot of different triggers that would do different steps to figure that out. So I'd have to times two different things together. I would then have to divide it by 100. I would then have to set the variable that amount to another variable and so forth. And then, so it just took up a lot of triggers to do something pretty simple. So that's where something like this will help, where you can actually do this inside of JavaScript with one trigger. It does take a little bit of code, but you could actually take the code snippet below the video and you could just copy that and paste it and just adjust it for your own variables and make it a whole lot easier. So let's go ahead and dive in and look at this example real quick. So I'm going to go in and preview this example, and really you can create whatever type of example that you want. Just have these two entry fields and then also display the two variables, two different variables, and we'll talk about what those variables are. So here's my two entry fields. So I'm going to go ahead and enter in my rent is $800, and I'm going to go ahead and say my monthly income is $1,500 there. Just entering in some random numbers, and then I'm going to click on figure totals. Now, what figure totals does is it shows this text right here, and it has two different places where it's displaying some variables. The first place is figuring out the percentage of these numbers of my rent. How much of a percentage is it compared to my monthly income? I'm kind of just using it as a random number. I'm going to show you how complex you can get with math in JavaScript as well. And even though it says zero is the interest over the next 12 months, we're not really going to do that. We're going to do something else there just to show you kind of the complexity that you can do here. So let's go ahead and start taking this step by step here. And we're going to add a JavaScript trigger, and then we're going to start to, when you're working with JavaScript, you have to pull the content, because we're going to pull this content right here, these two text entry fields. The first thing we have to do is pull the content into our own little JavaScript world. Now that we can have pulled that, we can now work with it. We can do calculations with the numbers that have come in, and then we push. And so there's always this pull the information from Storyline as is, work with it without adjusting anything actually in Storyline yet, and then push it back. I'll point those two parts out once we get to them, but there's always that pull and then push, pull, push. Whenever you're working with JavaScript and variables inside of Articulate Storyline 360, just keep that in mind, that you're gonna pull the information and you're gonna push the information. Now, if for some reason you don't need to pull information from a variable, you still need to grab it, whatever variable that you're going to use, you still need to reference it in order for you to be able to push it back. So you still need to do that pull, push kind of thing. All right, so let's go ahead and go in and add our JavaScript trigger. Right now, I'm just changing this results to normal, so it shows up, and I want the JavaScript to happen before that actually shows up. So let's go ahead and add a JavaScript trigger inside of Articulate Storyline. And it's already here on execute JavaScript trigger because I had that already to go, but you can select the drop-down box and go down to execute JavaScript right there. And then I'm going to have this happen as soon as the user clicks on this button called do calc. Go ahead and open this up. Now, the first thing we need to do, and this is the first step with any type of JavaScript, is you need to reference the player. Because keep in mind that the JavaScript is kind of separate from the player. We are doing something that's separate, but then we're pushing it back. That's really how this JavaScript window works. So I'm going to go ahead and reference that first item here. So I just have my code snippet off to the side. I'm just going to paste that here. So this is a comment. Anytime that you see this slash slash, that is actually commenting out, and that's for your own reference. That way, if you come back to here, you know you can leave a comment on what you were doing, and it makes more sense, basically. So right now, I'm just saying storyline player, and then I'm creating a variable let's, and then calling that variable player, and then equals get player open close parentheses, and that's how we talk to the storyline player. Now, anytime I want to talk to the storyline player to be able to pull information or to get information, I only have to use the word player. So I'm just kind of setting that up to be able to shorten the code a little bit later. That's really what that is if you want to shorten code, you create the content inside of a simple variable name, and then you reference that later on. So let's go ahead. And what we need to do is we need to pull the entry num one and the entry num two, which are the variables of these different text fields at the moment. So whatever the information is pulled in, we need to pull that information and store it inside of this little JavaScript world, basically. We're creating a little world and we need to store that information inside of this world so we can then use it and then push it back. All right, so I'm gonna go back into my little snippets here and I'm going to copy these snippets and I'm gonna come in here and paste those snippets. So right here, here's my comment, get two numbers from storyline. So we're creating a variable. Right here is basically how you create a variable inside of JavaScript. Now you don't need to type this out. You could just copy the snippets from the video below and you could just paste it inside of storyline. What I like to do is just walk you through the code to hopefully make it so it's not so scary. And it makes a little bit more sense of what's actually happening because the key is not for you to memorize the code, in my opinion, it's for you to know how to use the different snippets and things that you find in order to accomplish what you need. So that is the key, and that's why I wanted to just walk through it here. All right, so we're first of all creating a variable called num1, so number one, and then we're creating a variable called number2. Now this code right here, player, we're referencing this right here, so we're gonna talk to the storyline player, and then we're calling a function called getVar. Now in that function, inside of parentheses, we're wanting to get the var, and we put this inside of quotes as well, but we're wanting to get the variable called entry num1, which is exactly what we've created here inside of storyline. So this is just a way for us to be able to get the value of whatever that variable is and store it inside of our own little JavaScript world so we can work with it. And we're doing the same thing with entry num2. So at this point, I have the numbers inside of my own little JavaScript world here, my JavaScript window, and now I can do some calculations. So let's go ahead and come down a couple lines, and I'm gonna add a comment that says complex math. So the first thing we're doing is, if we're gonna do these calculations, I want to store them inside of a new number, inside of a new variable. And anytime you're storing information, you're wanting to create a variable. Just like you do a storyline, if you're storing information that's gonna go across different pages, like the user's name or something like that, you're going to create a variable. What you do inside of storyline, like the different triggers, is exactly the same that you do inside of JavaScript. It's just the way that you write it, basically. So you're already working with JavaScript principles when you're working with storyline triggers. I just wanted to point that out. So let's go ahead and we want to figure out the percentage. So usually you keep the name something similar or something that makes sense here, so percentage. Now what I can do is I can use those values. So I could actually say num1, and then I'm going to divide that by 2, or num2, and then I need to times it by 100. But to times it, I need to wrap these two numbers in here so the calculations happen first. Just like you were to do like math, just write it out, basically. That's really all that I'm doing here. So I'm gonna say num1 divided by num2, and then we're gonna times it by 100. And then I'm going to end that with a semicolon. Now a semicolon is basically just a period because with code, you're just giving list of instructions. You're telling storyline or your website exactly what to do. And you're giving them commands, and then at the end of the command, you're giving a period. And that's really what that semicolon means. It's just that's the end of the command. So in this case, we're having num1 divided by num2, and we're timesing that by 100. Now, this is not going to give me a nice rounded number. This is going to give me a number that's point something, 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 something. It's going to be pretty crazy. So there is a function inside. And when I say a function, that's basically a list of commands. There is a function that is default inside of JavaScript that allows you to take any number and just round it. So it's a simple function, and all you have to do is wrap the command here or the number inside of another parentheses here or inside of parentheses for the entire calculation here. So I just put that here. And then in front of here, I have to type math.round. You just have to copy and paste this, but I'm just walking through that this is how you take that number, that calculation, and anything inside that parentheses, any type of calculation that's going on, will actually now give you a rounded number. All right, so let's go ahead and push this back to Storyline. So now that we have that calculation happening, so we're gonna push to Storyline. We did our pull, we did our calculations, and now it's time to push. And so that's the very last thing when you're working with Storyline is to push the content back. So to do this, all I have to do is go to player. So we're talking to that player. And now this is another function inside of Storyline. So we just say set var. So we're calling a function, a list of commands, and then we're going to pass in whatever the new information is. And so first of all, we have to reference what variable we're going to update. So inside of quotes, we're going to do the same thing that we did here. So in fact, I can just copy and paste this right here. Then before the parentheses, we add a comma, and then we add the new number that we're passing in. Now, I don't have to do that calculation. I could pass in 190 or whatever I wanted to here. But because we did that calculation, all I have to do is basically copy and paste that. And that now has that new number. Now, Storyline has the updated number. And anywhere that I'm displaying that number, I'm going to go ahead and click OK here. And then I'm going to click OK. Now I am displaying that number right here. You can see the calc one. Oh, actually I forgot to update it to the right one. So let's go back in here and we're not pushing it back to entry number. We're actually pushing it to a new number. So we're doing it to calc one. And so that way this has the updated number. I forgot about that. Otherwise we would be updating this number if we didn't push it to a new variable. So I do have a variable called calc one and calc two. So calc one is right here. Calc 2 is right here. So we want to make sure that this happens before we show that text. So I'm going to move that up. And let's go ahead and hit publish now. And I'm just going to publish this to the web. We don't need all the extra SCORM files that get published when you publish to an LMS. We're just going to preview it here. I'm going to go ahead and double click on this folder and then double click on story.html. And we're going to jump to the complex math page here or whatever page that you've created. And let's say we now have $800. Out of a $1,500 monthly total, I'm gonna go ahead and click on figure totals. And you can see that 53% right there. 53% of my monthly budget is going towards rents. That is working. It gives me a nice rounded number here. So let's go ahead and play with this one a little bit. Let's do some more complex calculations and get a real big number here. So I'm gonna go in back into my example. I'm going to go back to JavaScript here, and I'm going to close out this little example here just so when I publish out a new version, it doesn't have any remembrance, or like it doesn't remember the old version, basically. So I'm going to go in here, and we're going to do a different calculation here. So I'm going to create another variable where I will store my other calculation. So math, complex math equals, now let's go a little crazy here. So we're going to say num1 times, and then we're gonna say, let's times that by 500. And then we're going to add, and we're gonna add the num2, or let's times that by 800. And then we're going to divide all of that by 6. And this is just to show you that you can, with normal math, basically, that you would type out or that you've seen on, you know, in elementary, high school, whatever, that type of math, you could type all that out and get that calculation into one variable. So now the complex math is there. What I need to do is set that vars, the calc 2. So I'm going to say player.setVar. And then we're going to pass in what variable, Storyline variable, we're going to update, which is going to be that calc 2. And then we're going to pass in this complex math. That's the number that we're going to pass in and update into Storyline. That's it. So you can do all this calculation that you want. You could do division, multiplication. You can add whatever. You can add it several different times to get the exact number that you want. So you update all that here, and then you update the variable inside of Storyline once you've done all of that complex math. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. Now, math was never my strong suit. So if you're wanting to look at different possible math, you could probably find a formula or something by Googling it. But I'm going to go ahead and click on publish here, and I'm going to click publish there. All right, so it is now published. I'm going to go back to my folder, double click on the story.html file, click on complex math. Let's use the same number. So let's say 800 and then 1500, and then click on figure totals. So now it says 53%, and then it says 600,000, and it doesn't separate it by the comma. There is some JavaScript to be able to separate it by a comma and everything like that, but we're not going to get into that part if you did want to have that. But keep in mind, once you're getting into large numbers, it does not separate it by the comma or anything like that. So, but it allows me to quickly, with one trigger, allow me to go in and do complex math and even build on and updates, you know, different variables throughout the course and something and different things like that. So I at least wanted to show you this. If you can get this done in a couple triggers inside a Storyline without having to use JavaScript, so that may work a little bit better. But at least you know that this is a possibility now, and that you can do as much complex math as you need to in order to figure out different percentages and so forth and display that back to the learner. So hopefully this was helpful for you. If you have any other questions, go to my YouTube channel and leave a comment down below and let me know what else you want to see. What other types of JavaScript triggers or snippets do you want to see? Or if there's something that didn't make sense in this video, I do respond to all of the different comments. So go ahead and go over there and leave the comment. And then also, if you wanted to check out my website, go to all the previous blog posts. You can see all the different JavaScript and Storyline videos that I've published. You can also download free templates, Articulate Storyline templates, different game templates, as well as XAPI templates. And then you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z inside of Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. And also head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button if you like the video, and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you get notified of all future videos that come out. This really helps my channel, allows my channel to grow, allows me to keep producing these videos for you to be able to up your learning development game and improve in the skills that are needed for learning development. But that's all that I have for today. So if you have any other questions, again, head on over to my YouTube channel and ask the question. If not, I'll see you next time. Thanks, everyone.